What's up, guys? This is Roughneck Actual, and you have reached the Roughnecks e-com channel. If you want to learn how to make money online or offline, then you need to be right here. I'm a seven-figure Amazon seller. I'm also an honorably discharged Air Force veteran. Graduated from Penn State and started a career as a software engineer and leveraged that to build my businesses. If you guys have any questions on how to make money, you're going to find all your answers right here, so stay tuned.
So let's recap everything that happened in Miami on this trip, besides getting tattooed and all this. Had some super fresh squeezed juice. That was nice. That place was awesome. Delicious. I instantly felt better after that. I don't know, whenever I get fresh fruit or something like that, or get like fresh squeezed juice, I just feel better. I'm like a child. I just feel better. It's delicious. And then of course the tattoo that you guys can't see. I got my entire back tattooed over the trip. It's still kind of shiny because of the whole healing process or whatever. But yeah, so once that's done, you guys can check it out. You know, there's going to be some clips and some footage in here of me getting tattooed, almost wanting like a little baby because it did not feel good. Didn't hurt as much as getting tattooed on the stomach, but tattooed on the spine just definitely did not feel good. I was not a happy camper with that. And then...
If I had a back the size of this Khalifa's, we would have been done already.
Don't start thinking that way.
Yeah, Brap has some big things coming, you know, in the future, so it was cool linking up with him and getting breakfast and stuff. He almost got beat up by his lady because the waitress was a little bit too friendly. So that was funny to witness. You guys had to have been there to see that. See what else? Oh, I got to take the McLaren out, you know, of course, on 195 heading to Miami Beach. It's a trip. All right, so if you guys have not been to Miami, so Miami Beach and mainland Miami are separated, so you have to take either like 195 or one of the bridges to get across. 195 is open as hell, so if you have any type of supercar, they can really get up and boogie, or any type of car for that matter, they can get up and boogie. And no, I'm not talking about your K-Swap Civics. Your car can do that reasonably comfortably, you're gonna have some fun. You're gonna have a whole lot of fun. So if you stay on Miami Beach and then you head over on 195, man, you could just boom blast there. Oh, by the way, sorry Brap that I dusted your ass in your Corvette. Yeah, he got dusted. He don't want to come out and say it. That's why he's buying a McLaren, by the way, because that Z06 was no match. I had the top down. Randy can vouch. So if you guys need to check on that, yo, head over to my man Brap's channel and be like, yo, Randy, did Rico air that Z06 out? Yes, I did. I mean, it has more torque, so like, you know, from a 40 roll, he got the jump just because it, you know, it's just more torque. It's a bigger motor. It's just designed that way. But man, woo, he was gone. I was waving. I don't think he put the video out. Brap, where the video, man? Where's that video? Where the video of me just choo-chooing away, baby. Yeah, I just had to say that. Nah, he's getting a McLaren. He's jumping on the Mac bandwagon. You guys should already know. He's looking to get a 720S in the next few months. So big shout out to that. I actually might end up, you know, getting a 765. If I get a 765, I'll probably end up getting rid of a 600 for it. Just because the 765 is just a leaps and bounds like better car. I love my car. I love my McLaren. But you know, I'd probably end up getting a 765, especially since drag times just ran like the fastest quarter mile time with a production car. I mean, the thing ran 9.3 at 150 miles an hour on stock tires, showroom stock. That's fast as hell. So I mean, the track was obviously you know, well prepped, but whatever. So we'll see about that. I don't know. Maybe I'll do something different. Maybe I'll go down there and get a Performante. Would you guys want to see that? Would you guys want to see a Performante on the channel so we can twin turbo it? You know, I'm not sure. I'm debating on that. I really do want to get a Performante and I want to twin turbo it, but I don't know about daily reliability. Whereas like my Mac, I can drive every day a twin turbo Hurricane. I don't know if I'm gonna be driving that every day, just in fear that something's gonna fucking grenade. But we shall see on that. We'll talk about it. You know, drop your comments down there below. Make sure you like this video, by the way, if you guys haven't done so already. Let's see, what else did we do? Oh no, that was the previous trip. The previous trip, we did some pretty cool stuff. I was out there with Brad and we went to this one club, and I think I just, I don't know why I did. I hit somebody in the face with a fistful of money.
My nigga.
So yeah, that was exciting, but yeah, that wasn't this trip. Yeah, I don't think we didn't do too many exciting things this trip. Oh, we got some photo shoots done for this little side project that I have going on. Well, not really side project because it's a business now, but you guys will be finding out about that in Q1. You know, like obviously you guys know I do Amazon automation and stuff, but I'm also trying to automate a different process, you know, for, we'll just say it's in the influencer space and stuff like that. So I think it's going pretty well. You know, so people who, you know, need extra money and don't really know how to make extra money, I'm going to automate that process for them and, you know, hook them up. So that's another project I have coming. So if you guys are, you know, waiting to see how that goes, you know, if you need an extra like 3 to 5, maybe even 10 or 20K each month, depending on certain aspects, then I think I can, you know, make that work for you guys. And guess what? It's not going to cost anything. There will be no upfront charge for this type of automation. You know, so yeah, that's something that people, you know, are like, what? Really? I can get an automation out there, but it's not going to be for everybody. All right. So I'm just going to preface it with that. But yeah, man, so that this trip was pretty dope, man. We got a lot of content. I got my back done. Take it to the river. You know, got to go, you know, see a little bit more of Miami. I mean, I try to get out and, you know, learn the area because that's definitely a place that I want to be, you know, in the future or whatever. I want to take my kids down and just have a good time, you know, get a condo down there or whatever. But, you know, I really got to see a little different side of Miami. You know, I got to spend more time, like, among the people.
Just eat every 2 hours.
Are you going to eat?
We all do.
Hi, baby.
How are you?
Hi,
Amy. How are you?
This is the man in charge here.
I did
have a good day, bro.
John, nice to meet you.
Do you guys know each other?
Not yet. Well, now, yeah, I just met him today, yeah. How's it going,
baby?
Do
you have to come with us?
You said where are you going?
We're going to have some lunch.
We'll be back, though.
Yeah, yeah. Just order food here.
Because we want to, like, sit.
We want to sit and have, like, a real meal.
Yeah, well, he was dealing with a fiasco.
I ended up getting, so instead of me staying in Fountain Blue like I always do, I was like, I'm going to get an Airbnb so that way I can be close to my tattoo artist.
Yeah.
Get there, the Airbnb already has somebody in there, and I tried getting the guy up for 3 days before I got here, no message whatsoever.
Oh, get, oh my God, this is what we needed.
Yep. Surprise.
So to speak, and kind of ingrain myself in some of the Miami culture, which I try to do a little bit more every single time that I go, but it, you know, it doesn't always work out that way because we're usually busy shooting content for you guys and all that. Yeah, we found a Bitcoin mining place that was actually pretty cool. Yeah, the Bitcoin place, yeah, with the little mining rigs with the yellow background wall. Yeah, so we got that. That was actually pretty awesome. I did a video, if you guys didn't know, I did a video about you know, automation while you're not making any money. It's on the channel. Check it out. Let's see. Yeah, I don't know, man. This trip was pretty good. You know, I think everybody should go to Miami and enjoy it. It's like Vegas, but not as dirty. Like, not as disgusting. I guess, you know, you're not going to be dealing with people smoking in casinos all the damn time. Not that Vegas is bad. Like, I actually like Vegas outside of this trip. If I could pick places to live, it would be Miami, Vegas, and then LA. Cali's just super, super expensive, which is why it's, you know, the last on the list. Vegas is really nice, especially outside the strip. It has just amazing restaurants. There's a lot to do. I like the climate and the atmosphere. It's kind of family friendly outside the strip. The schools suck, though. The school systems aren't all that great. So, I mean, what do you think? Like, what do you expect? It's a make-believe city built in the middle of the desert to wash mob money. And then people just happen to move around there. So, of course, you can't expect school systems to be that great. And then, of course, there's Miami, where I feel that it's kind of the best of everything. You know, you get the beaches, you get nice weather, you get, you know, beautiful scenery. You know, obviously, the ladies down there, you know, and if you're into the, you know, men or whatever, don't matter. Everybody down there is looking good. Like, it's rare that you're going to find, like, a really, really overweight person in Miami. Like, they got some little thickums down there, but it ain't like out here in the Northeast where, you know, you got some husky individuals. Like, down there, like, appearances are pretty much everything, so you got some real good-looking people. So that's just something, like, you know, if you want to be a place where they got some baddies, whether it's guy or girl, because baddies can be either or, okay? It can be either or it could be gender neutral. I don't know. They's, them's? Man, I don't care, man. Baddies can go for whatever the hell you want it to go for, okay? Like, we ain't even gonna get into gender politics and all this stuff, because I don't know that shit. I'm just gonna be real with you. I don't know nothing about that. But yeah, they got some baddies down there, so it's a good time. And then, of course, they got all the cars and stuff. And yeah, so I got another trip coming up. I'm not gonna be shooting too much content on that one. It's gonna be me and my friend going down, you know, just living life, because I don't ever take them on any trips. And he mentioned it, so I'm like, yo, we got to do something fun, just kind of hang out and you know, enjoy the Miami scenery, drive some cars around. You know, he don't want to ship his Porsche down. I don't know why, other than the price, but, you know, it is what it is. Maybe we'll rent him something nice, because I'm shipping my car down for sure. I might even get another one when I'm down there. Depends. I've been talking some ideas, so maybe you guys will see a new car come to the channel. I don't know. We'll see. I don't know if I'll give up the Mac for it, but it depends. It depends on if the numbers look right. But yeah, so maybe I'll link up with Q too. I don't know if Q's gonna be too busy to link up. I know you guys have been asking about it in DM, like, oh yeah, can you link up with Q while you're down here? We can talk some Forex, but we'll see. So yeah, that was my Miami recap. It was a good time, lots of sunshine. It was great. I had a lot of fun. So yeah, and there were some videos that were shot for it. You guys should be checking them out. So yeah, I'm out. So be safe, be smart. Make sure you guys check the links below in the description and all that shit. And yeah, peace.
Just to give you an idea of how hard I work, I did approximately 3,500 videos in 4 years. You know what I'm saying? So there's only 365 days in a year, right? So I was shooting two or three times a day, and it was only 15 second edits back then. So there's, I didn't do minute edits and shit like that. So 15 seconds. So I was shooting three, four, or five people a day, and for the brands too. And then I'm coming back, and it's, you know, there were not too many cuts because it was 15 seconds, right?